The man of the hour, Kevin Tan, president of Emerate. Hi, Kevin. Good to have you on the show.
Hi, Mimi. Thanks for having me on your show.
Okay, so big day. Congratulations. How are you feeling?
Thank you. I was feeling great. It's been quite many months in the making, but we're very happy to finally launch our REIT today, October 1, the first day of the fourth quarter. A very exciting month as well, and a very exciting quarter for the Philippines.
And it seems like investors are happy because Emerate shares are already trading higher by half of 1%, 16.58 right now from 16.10. And you did have overwhelming demand, right? That's why you had to move the listing from yesterday to today.
Yes. We've had overwhelming demands from the institutional, but more importantly, very overwhelming demands from the retail investors as well. So yeah, that's the reason why we had to move it by one day. But I think they are all very attracted by the attractive yields we've provided. And I think the growth story is also quite compelling as well.
Before we get to the growth story, I wanted to get the personal side of the story. Can you recall the first time that you had this conversation about REIT and possibly getting into REIT, maybe with your dad or with your team?
You know, the REIT, we have always been interested to be part to launch a REIT. You know, our office building is our office business is one of our largest, and it's the largest actually in the country. And it's we were always looking for ways to spin that off. But you know, it took a long while for the REIT law to actually be to make sense. Secretary Dominguez has really done a lot. It has been very decisive and has really put the proper policies in place to make the REIT possible, or REIT, REITs possible. And that's why you see one REIT after another being launched. No, we think that this is just the beginning. There will be many, many more REITs to come. But yeah, that's always been in our horizon, and it's a way for us to actually allow for investments into our office business and allow for investments as well into our very thriving township business.
The competition in REITs certainly heating up. Kevin, what makes MREIT stand out? What makes you a cut above the rest? What's in it for investors?
Well, you know, we have a very long runway of growth, as we've said. We've only put in about 16% of our assets currently today. We are already committing to put in as much as 100,000 square meters next year in two tranches. One first in the first quarter, and the second one before our first anniversary. And these assets will come from our existing three townships. That's Eastwood, McKinley Hill, and Iloilo Business Park. For 2023, we are now looking at putting in assets from our famed Uptown Bonifacio development. Currently, we have about 331,000 square meters of built-up space there, and we have about 70,000 square meters that are coming online by next year, and we continue to expand there. And I think that's a very, very exciting development. So we hope to be more than double of what we are today by the end before the end of 2023. And looking forward, because we have still a tremendous runway of growth and still a vast portfolio of assets, we hope to be 1 million square meters before 2030.
And that would make you the largest REIT in terms of floor size, not just in the Philippines, but in Southeast Asia.
Yes, that's correct. That's correct. Yeah, that would make us one of the largest in Southeast Asia.
Are there plans, Kevin, to inject other sorts of assets into the portfolio? Because you are into tourism as well.
Yes. As of now, well, we do have a small hotel asset in the current REIT, but that is part of an office building, and the yields there are assured. So, but in the foreseeable future, we view this as 80-90% office REIT, you know, with the occasional retail component, because some of our office buildings do have a small retail component on the ground floor. But the vision is for this to be an office REIT, pure play office REIT.
And so essentially, you are betting on the office space in the property sector. What makes you so confident that it will continue to be the strongest driver for growth?
You know, we've
Work
already
from
but
home
this
not going to be for everyone
no,
forever?
you know, this it's been you know, this industry through the pandemic has been one of the most resilient industries in the Philippines. It's the only industry, one of the few industries that's have grown in terms of revenues and headcount. And in fact, this year we have already seen a rebound in demand, no? Especially from sectors that were put on hold last year, that is related to BPO, like travel, hospitality. Those were all put on hold, but this year has been there's been a rebound because of the rebound in the US, and that's why we've seen an uptick in demand. And that's why another thing about this week is that our current yield right now, there's already going to be an upside because we have already been able to lease out all of our office buildings in the REIT. So we're now 99% leased out right now. So you will start to see an increase or an upside in the yield already for the fourth quarter and the first quarter next year. So it's a reflection of how resilient really this industry is, despite all the challenges that exist currently still with this pandemic.
And all of these properties in your portfolio are top tier, top grade properties, grade A buildings, PESA accredited.
Grade A office building, PESA accredited, and more importantly, they are located within our three very mature townships, which is a thriving ecosystem, which gives the assets added value or enhances its value. I think that there is really very compelling reasons for both employees and the and the companies to continue to operate in these township ecosystems, you know, where there's an abundance of housing, there's an abundance of amenities, and it's just quite frankly, you know, it's just a lot safer, it's just a lot more convenient, no? And that's what gives these assets their underlying value.
Okay, final question, Kevin. Big picture now of the economy. What is your outlook on the big economy, the Philippine economy, the recovery? I mean, Metro Manila, we're extending until the first half of October under alert level 4. The Delta variant is still out there. The cases remain elevated. Well, what's your outlook for the recovery now?
You know, the way we see it is that we are making some progress. I learned as of 2 days ago, we've already vaccinated, the whole country vaccinated 45 million people. 22 million of that is actually second dose already. Half of that is in Metro Manila. That's why you see Metro Manila cases trending downwards. From the property sector side, we've been very surprised. We still see continued robust growth and demand in our property projects outside Metro Manila. Surprisingly, we're even getting a lot of demand from our tourism-related developments like Boracay, Twin Lakes, and Eastland Heights in Rizal. We see capital values or property prices continue to grow. For our condominium developments outside Metro Manila, the property prices have been growing at an average 7 to 10% since the start of the pandemic. For our lots development or our lots within our townships, we've seen tremendous growth, anywhere from 20 to 60% growth since the start of the pandemic. That's why in Megaworld, we say lots are king right now. And that's really, if you want to ask us what we're very focused on in the next 2 years, it's really going to be our tourism-related developments. And we are going to be developing more townships. We are actually launching a township. We launched township number 27 last week. We're launching township number 28 next week. And we hope to launch, hope to launch up to 32 townships within our, this is our 32nd year. So we'll hope to launch 32 townships within our 32nd year. So that's going to be from now until the first quarter next year.
Exciting times ahead. Very, very busy for you, Kevin. Thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations again on EMREIT.
Thank you, Mimi.